So let's look at a comparison between the three main deployments of WebTrends. The first deployment being one that is hosted by WebTrends. So this one is hosted in a data center somewhere in the US, and you have access to just the administration interface and certain FTP downloads if you have the capability to do so. Next, we have the on-premise version. This is where you install WebTrends software locally. This is a common installation which requires support from internal resources at your. And the third column we have is our managed services system. So we've broken down each key item here with a plus or an X to indicate whether it is supported or whether it is optimal for each item here. I'm going to go through a few of the key items in some greater detail, and we can get an idea of which items or which systems have a greater appeal in each area. So the first item is location in Canada. So with the hosted version of WebTrends, it's not located in Canada, and you don't have full access to the data center or to the data that is collected. It's governed by any rules or terms that are listed by the collection network in hosted environment. For on-premise, the reverse is there. You have full access to your data. It's stored locally on your servers in Canada, and there are no questions about the origin or usage of that data. Similarly, with managed services, our data is hosted in Canada, and you have full access to that data, and there is full understanding of where that data is and which rules and laws govern that data. Next, we have no hardware required. In hosted, it's great. You don't have to worry about procuring hardware or managing any resources, making sure that the uptime is there, and making sure that there is electricity powering your hardware, or that someone is there to monitor security updates and patches and other regular requirements to ensure that WebTrends is running. With on-premise, you have to do all those things. So it's quite a lot more involved from that standpoint. There are a lot of hidden expenses that go beyond just the standard internal costing of having servers managed in that method. You might find that having downtime on a WebTrends system isn't as simple as just a standard Windows service being running or not running. There's many more moving pieces to it than that. With WebTrends managed services, we have a lot more support for you in terms of hardware. We manage the hardware, and we take care of all of the details of what WebTrends requires to run successfully. So we have quite a powerful network and hardware solution set up for you, so you don't have to worry about it. I'll skip on to a couple ones further down here for speed and brevity. There is no cost for profiles plus other things such as translation tables, export reports, custom reports, various other add-ons. That's true for both on-premise and for managed services, but with hosted services, that's just not the case. There's going to be an added cost as you need to process more and more with various levels of detail required for your analytics, especially as organizations become more complex and reliant on web analytics and web trends more. They will find that these profiles and these additional features become much more useful and valuable. For the next one we have here, free data access. Free data access is a great way to get full access to your logs and full access to all of the data that is processed and made available by your WebTrends system. So with the hosted version, free data access is just something that's not available. You only have limited access to the very specific functions that you purchase or procure through the hosted environment. Again, that's completely different on the on-premise and the managed system. You have full access to all of those files, all of those data connections, all of those exports. There isn't anything that will limit your access to that data.
I just want to jump in for a second. For while this is we mentioned that the servers would be located in Canada. We also have a location. We also have the servers can also be hosted in the United States. So for our U.S. customers, we also have a facility in Texas.
Yes, thank you. Good point there, Nad. So you can have a specific location for your collection servers. So that's not a worry or an issue. That is fully flexible to your needs. For brevity, the last item here I'll cover is data security control. With the hosted environment, you don't have secure or data access controls over your data. It's completely managed in the hosted environment, and so you don't have access to who will control to who will access your data. The opposite is true for your on-premise and your managed systems. You have full access to that data, and your control and management of that data is much more granular. So you can allow certain people in your organization to access that data or not access that data. So that wraps up the comparison, and I'll pass it back to Nad for the remainder.
Yeah, so thanks Richard. So in addition to the basic support you receive with your Unalytics Managed Services implementation, we also offer the option of premium support, which would offer you unlimited upgrades and updates to your WebTrends Civic implementation, integrating WebTrends with company databases, email marketing tools, CRM, or even your corporate web portal. The option of VPN. We can also help you optimize your WebTrends reporting and even long-term storage of your log files. And so just to recap our talk on Unalytics Managed Services, it can empower you to minimize IT costs, focus your web analytics initiatives on its true purposes, which is reporting and optimization, not managing complex hardware architecture, ensuring IT focus on their essential tasks, leveraging reporting and insights more readily, easy access to your WebTrends reporting, and seamless access as well, and very importantly, feeling confident and secure that your reporting and data is being managed by experienced professionals, with the addition of redundant and backup servers, whether you're in Canada or the United States. So, reserve now, and if you have any questions, or you can reach out to me. My email you'll see in the next slide, and we can answer your questions, talk to you about pricing and implementation. We'll look for any questions that there are right now. If you have any questions, you can ask. You can email me, or you can use our custom hashtag. So I see that there are no questions, so I'm going to go ahead and assume that we covered off everything. In case things do come up, please feel free to email me, or you can tweet us, and we'll be glad to answer your questions. With that, I want to thank everybody for your time today, and I hope this presentation was helpful in seeing the value of Unalytics Managed Services for WebTrends. Thank you all, and have a great day. Actually, there was a question from Dennis. His question was, just to confirm in your managed version, the log files are stored in Canada, but not on my server, on yours, right?
So in this case, the log files, there's two locations that log files in an analysis system will be stored. The first level is the collection layer. So when it's initially collected, it's stored on the SDC server. So the SDC server will be, depending on whether your preferred location is Canada or in the US, it will be stored on that server initially. The next layer is the analysis layer. So where your analysis servers are stored, depending on whether you have managed SDC only or whether you have the entire managed SDC and analysis server, then you will likely be copying your SDC logs to your local analysis server. And that would then make it make your logs stored on those servers which are managed under your managed services account, but not necessarily on your local servers at your building, if that's what you're asking. So yes, your log files will be stored on your managed services servers, but not locally on your internal network. But you could, if you wanted to, download a copy of those logs right to your internal network or whatever you'd like for the purposes of doing additional analysis or various other number crunching on that log file.
So Dennis, I hope that answers your question. If you require any more detail, feel free to email me again, and we'll be happy to answer your question in more detail. There is one more question from Canadian Heritage. The question is the interface the WebTrends on-demand version?
Okay, so the interface is more than just that. So you will have the interface, the WebTrends UI interface. You will have the latest on-premise version of that interface, which gives you full access to the administration and the report data. You will have additional access to the machines themselves, so to the computers that are processing WebTrends. Those servers will be fully accessible to you. Perhaps in that question about whether it's the on-demand version, if you're asking whether it's version 10, it's not going to be version 10 from the start. Until version 10 is more fleshed out and ready for on-premise as a standard and fully supported solution for on-premise, it won't be available as a version 10. You will, however, have the Insight interface, the standard WebTrends UI, as well as all the administration components and features that add on into that. So I hope that answers your question there about the interface. Please send another question if I didn't fully cover that.
We got another question from Peter Bradley, and his question is, it seems these managed services focus on SDC log files. Is this true?
So there's two parts to managed services. One is SDC log files. That's a pretty important component of any WebTrends installation, because a lot more value can be had from the SDC log files. It is possible to have managed services process raw log files. That's completely an option, and it's not something that you must have SDC for, but we do highly recommend that you have your SDC server collecting data from your pages. You're just going to get so much more value with the SDC. So I hope that that answers that question, Peter. And again, if I didn't fully get to that question, then you can follow up with an additional one.
Okay, so since there are no other questions now, I will again thank everybody for joining us today, and we look forward to hearing from you. And please feel free to reach out to us with any questions or inquiries. Thank you all, and have a great afternoon.